Hey guys, in this video I'm going to show you how you can download your sound audio drive to your Windows, and I'm also going to show you some other debugging step in case if you have the same issue I had. My mic suddenly just went mute and I couldn't hear anything. So let's talk about what worked for me. I'm not going to say work for everyone, but this worked for me. So come up here and click on this link, Realtek HD Definition audio driver for Windows 10. So this is what we're going to click on. Now once we click on it, it's page going to open up. Basically what we want to do is to download the Windows drive for the audio, because I noticed mine is not showing. I'm gonna come back to that, why I came to that conclusion that my drive has been deleted. So let's go ahead and click on it. So we just wait for it to open up, and this is it right here. Nice. So you can come right here and click on download. It's about 600 and something MB. That's the size. So just go ahead and click on it. Once you click on it, it will start downloading. So just give it up to 15 to 10 minutes, depending on your internet speed, to install. Okay, so I have downloaded it already. So let me just open up my downloaded files right here. Okay, that's it. So I'm just gonna click on it, then just wait for it to open up. Okay, so this is it. And see right here is a zip file, so you have to extract it. Once you extract it, it will look just like other yellow file right there icon. Yep. So from there you're just gonna click on it, then open it up. But I'm also gonna leave the link in the description in case if you want to download it too. Note, I use a Lenovo laptop, so in case, I'm not sure it's going to work on every laptop, but you can try it out. So this is it. So I'm gonna come right here and click on the file, open it up. Okay, let's go. Okay, so if you want to extract it, you're just gonna click. So we're gonna come over and click on extract to. That's the one we're going to use, so just go ahead and click on that. Okay, so let me open it up. Once open up, you're gonna see this other folder. We're just going to click on it again. So we're gonna go ahead and scroll down. Okay, so this is what we want. So it says set up, so we're going to click on this. Once we click on it, our window is going to prompt us to allow, if we want to allow this application to run on the system. We're going to click on yes. That's not going to show in this. So once you click on that, it will start running. Once it's done installing on your system, it's going to shut down and restart again. So once it starts that process, that's gonna take up to like 10 to 15 minutes. This could depend on your type of system. But once it's done updating, your system is going to come back on, and from there, your audio is going to start working. You can now listen to music. So this is how it looks like. I'm gonna pause this because I've already done this process already. So I'm just gonna click on cancel. Yep. So after doing that, you have your system back and it's going to be working very well. Now let me show you some other things you might want to try out before just going ahead to download the audio drive. So I'm also going to leave the link to this site in the description, so that if you want to download the audio file drive, you can just go ahead and do that. But before that, you need to check if the audio drive has been deleted from your system, which is part of what I'm going to show you basically you need to go to your device manager, then check. If you don't see it there, just know okay, it might have been deleted or it's gone, so you may want to reinstall it again. Now, one of the other thing I will advise you to do is try updating your system. So this is it. Just go to your settings, then click update. So after clicking update, it brings us here to this page, says Windows update. So you will want to click check for updates. If there are any updates, it will start installing. Now this could take a much longer time, 30 to 1 hour. So you might just want to click on that, then just minimize the screen. This could take a long time. Then after that, you can see it says get the latest update as soon as they are available. So you can click on this if you have this option on your system. Okay, so right now it's checking for updates, so we're just going to let that keep on running. So now this is the reason why I decided to download the audio drive again. Each time I click on the speaker, I have this get help windows that pop up. It has some information there, but let me go ahead and check the device manager. Now that's what I want to do. Done, click on open. Now once it opens up, there's something I noticed. There was I could not find the audio drive for my Windows, which was really not good, because it clearly shows that something might have happened to it, and that was why the icon of the audio has a mark on it. So let's come over to settings, another place. Let's click on update and security. So what I want to do now is try updating. Okay, so that's already going on right now. Then let's come over to troubleshoot. Go ahead and click on that. So after clicking on that, we come to additional. Click on that, additional troubleshoot. Click on that and come to playing audio, run the troubleshoot. Now this is going to take up to some few minutes, 5 to 10 minutes at least to run. Once it's done, it will give you a result. Hopefully that might help, but if it doesn't, you might want to come over to play. Let's check play. Now once I clicked on my play, I didn't see any icon there. I suspected that something was wrong with my audio file, and that was why I decided to re-download it again. So that's it, guys. If you like this video, please go ahead and subscribe for more videos like this, and check out this video over here. Bye.